I'm out today exploring the Montreal River area. I'm now on the Montreal River. There's three hydro dams on this river, possibly four, that flood this river valley. And here's some beautiful scenery here at this location. The water here is very dark colored and full of tannins, which is from all the runoff from the bush here. Not uncommon for streams and rivers in the north here to be colored this way. And here's a sign they have posted here along the waterways. No rock climbing, no hiking, no boating, no swimming. But of course, nobody listened to that. It's not really that dangerous here at this location. Here's a good view of one of the hydro dams on the Montreal River. The train trestle that you see here, the ACR tour train crosses over top of this on its way to Agawa Canyon. This cement work is built right on top of granite, a Canadian shield rock. And we're going to go up here a little further and maybe get another view. Here we are at the power station just below the dam here. And here's a nice waterfall running over the Canadian shield granite. Looking down on the transformer or the power station there. And the Montreal River flowing southward, eventually going into Lake Superior. That's an awesome waterfall. Just a quick view of this plant here. It's called the common mullein plant. It's about 4 feet high. And has some nice yellow flowers at the very tip. And the Montreal River in the background. Nice. Look what I found here at the Montreal River Dam. Somebody left a nice example of a painted rock. Let's look on the back. Oh, look at that. Boyne City Rocks. Please post. Facebook, Boyne City Rocks. They must be leaving these around for people to find in different places. I guess I'm the lucky one to find one. Nate. Here I am on the train trestle, crossing over the dam. Very neat location. The train's not due by here for some time, so I'm walking around on this edge of this walkway here, next to the tracks. And we're looking down over the edge here to, looks like overflow our pipes that divert the water down into the generating station. And on the upstream side, nice river valley. Some beautiful rock faces way up out there. I'll try zooming in, but without a tripod, it's probably going to be pretty shaky. Yeah. And we continue to walk out the trestle. And here we're looking right down through the slats of this wooden walkway to maybe 100 feet below. Sorry about the wind noise. Look over the edge. Beautiful granite down there, all with quartz veins running through it. I'm looking directly downstream, downriver. To the hydro station and the valley beyond. Here I'm looking directly down at the overflow spillway. At times of high waters or spring, they would open this up and the water would come way down over these rocks. And let's have a look here on the upstream side, the dam. You can see the walkways and the gate here they would lift to release water. Beautiful view. I'm on the windward side once again. I probably have trouble the wind overpowering the microphone. But here's some quick view of the steel structure underneath the trestle. Ah, here comes the tour train now. I'm not in a very good position, but some video is better than no video. That's the Agawa train tour, Agawa Canyon. Here he goes. Very neat. I'm on my end to have a close-up view of the wind turbines. They're up in the mountains up here. And I've come across all these black-eyed Susans. Amazing. Beautiful sight. Everywhere.
If anybody should know what these blue flowers are, they're interspersed throughout these black eyed Susans. And the bumblebees love them. I don't know what these are. Feel free to comment. Just a quick view here of this area. My video battery is almost dead. From one of the high points on the Montreal River Valley. Well, I made it up to one of the power generation windmills here. Very impressive. They're huge once you're standing at the bottom of them. You can hear the hum of energy being produced, or the turbine turning, I'm not sure which it is. Let's see if we can get a different angle on this. Here's another view of the wind turbine. Very neat from here. Although they call it green energy, I'm not in total agreement with that. All the metals in producing this comes from mining, so it's not all that green. Here we're looking at the very foundation of the windmills. The large fasteners must be bolts underneath these black plastic covers. And very solid, thick metal. Very heavy duty steel, a lot of steel in that. Welded seams, a lot of metals, all come from mining. Not all that green, is it? And looking up, my battery's almost dead. Hopefully I can get some more of this in. Looking way up there. And of course the very thick, heavy-duty cement slab. Lots of concrete. That's not all green either. And these only produce electricity when there's wind, which is about 30% of the time. Hydroelectric, in my view, is the ultimate clean energy. Let's have a walk around here, the side. Access doors here. Steps. Is locked. Here you can hear a lot of noise inside. Here's a tag on the base of the wind turbine. Apparently they're manufactured by GE, and it gives all the stats on this tag. All due to the weathering and reflection on it. You probably can't read it in this video. See if I can see some. Maximum survival wind speed 52.5, I don't know if that's kilometers or miles per hour. Cutout wind speed, which if it's too high of a wind speed, it'll shut down. That doesn't make sense. Looks like 25. Interesting, anyway. Oh, here we go. GE generators. Pensacola, Florida, USA. Here I am back in the Montreal River area, or I should say still in the Montreal River area. I've come across this old, I don't know if you'd call it an impeller or what, it would be from inside one of the hydro generating stations. It's got stainless steel fins on it. And the water would have been forcing or passing through this, spinning it and producing electricity, I would think. Approximately 8 feet high, 5 feet in diameter at the top. It's a V-shaped. And you have this welded steel construction here to hold it in place. Probably why they work on it. I had it removed. Let's get up here and have a closer look at these. Yeah, look how thick they are. Very solid. All right. Just using my final few seconds of video up here, crossing over the Montreal River, one of the dams here, a view down below. And just ahead, over the dam here, and to the right, the water.